What's good, YouTube? You know who it is. Chris Jones, representing Pump Chasers. So check it out, you already know. I'm rocking that cut-off sleeve, and I'm rocking that large. I got those joggers on, rocking the large, because I'm a large nigga, you feel me? Go to pumpchasers.com, get your 30 minimum. Now, before I start real quick, I got a beginner program coming. I'm actually recording tutorials right now. This is one of the tutorials I'm recording. My tutorials are already good, but I feel like since this is a beginner program, I need to go more in depth on some of my exercises. And the press down is one of them. I'll come over here real quick. So guys, this is the tricep cable press down. And off the jump, I don't like the word press when it comes to the triceps. And let me tell you why. Because the triceps, guys, is not a pressing muscle. Look. It flexes and extends. Look at the wider arc. See how it opens and closes? That's all an elbow does. It flexes and extends. It flexes and extends. It only has two functions, two very simple functions. And if you try to make it do something, and if you try to make it do what it's not designed to do, that's where the injuries come. That's where the pain comes, because you're doing shit you got no business doing. Think about the train tracks. The wheels gotta stay right in line with those tracks. Anything outside of that, the train is not on the tracks, and you gotta have a really bumpy ride. That's just how fitness. If you try to force your joints to do shit it got no business doing, you're gonna be in a hell of a ride. Lots of injuries in your future, trust me. Now check this out real quick. I don't like the word press down because triceps are a hinging joint. See, it's a hinging joint. Look at the door. See how the door opens and closes? Notice, it doesn't open straight like this. It doesn't open in a straight line. It hinges, look. It opens, it's a hinging joint. See that? A hinging joint. That's exactly how the elbow moves. The only way you can press is with the shoulder. The shoulder has several functions. You can have internal rotation, external rotation. You have flexion, you have extension, you have abduction, you have adduction. It has several functions, guys. That's where the pressing comes from. That's where the pulling comes from. Let me show you. All the pressing like this, like a punch you're throwing, it all comes from the shoulder. Think of the hands like hooks. Now look, I'm pressing with my shoulder. I'm pressing with my shoulder, right? So gravity comes straight up and down. And we know we move in rotary fashion, right? We move in a rotary fashion. So when we're pushing straight up, we're not really pushing straight. We're pushing in a circle. Look at the shoulder. The shoulder moves like this. So if I'm pushing in a straight line with a joint that moves in a rotary fashion, that means at some point, things are gonna go backwards, right? So look, like in a fair, when you see those Ferris wheels, where you're sitting on a ride and it kind of rolls, eventually you get to the top and then you come back down. Check this out. I'm pressing. I'm pressing. Now look, that's where the hinging joint comes in. As I'm pressing forward, the tricep comes in to extend. That way I can point straight up. Because like I said, the shoulders roll. Up, 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 up. And then triceps. So with that said, you do not press with your triceps. You press with your shoulders. So we don't wanna be doing this. We don't wanna be doing that. We just want to let the hinging joint do its job. That way the triceps get all the work. So look, set your shoulder and your elbow in a fixed position. And it's gonna vary person to person. It's gonna vary how long your limbs are. Like if you got short humerus but really long forearms, the angle best for you is gonna be different. If you like me and I've got pretty even arms, then it's gonna be different. Also, the height you set the thing on matters. Obviously, if I were to put this at the fucking ceiling, you're gonna notice the difference, right? You're gonna have this way up here, and this right here is gonna be pulling back. You're gonna struggle to try to keep it still. So guys, when it comes to this, just have it high enough to where when you come back up, you're not touching the stack. So have it high enough to where you can do the exercise without it touching the stack. Don't make it any higher than it has to be. When it's higher than it has to be, you're forcing the cable to pull away from you, and you want full control of the cable. I know it sounds like I'm being too picky, but trust me, once you get into the heavyweight, every little detail matters. So look, I got it about right here, about 2 notches away from the top. Making some weight on here. All right, now look. Come and just set your elbows. You're right here, it feels good. I feel it right on my lateral head of my tricep, right? But I feel it a little bit right in my elbow. I wanna save my joints. So instead of pressing from here, maybe I extend my shoulder back a little bit. See, I extend my shoulder back a little bit, and let me try to push down that way. So instead of pushing from here where it hurts my elbow at the bottom, I'm gonna try this, like that. I got one leg in front of the other, I'm keeping everything still, and I'm just focused on the shoulder, on the elbow joint, the hinging joint. That feels amazing, right there. And control it, don't drop it, control it. Control it down, control it up. Control it down, control it up. Control it down, control it up. And just squeeze with every rep. Squeeze with every rep. Squeeze with every rep. Don't throw into it, don't lean into it. Let the triceps do all the work. All right? And do it with the stack. Like I said, guys, I'm not promoting light pussy weight. What I'm promoting is, do not sacrifice your form for more weight. The form is going to ensure all the tension is going to the right place. Like I just told you guys, I had to extend my shoulder back just a little bit to take pain off my elbow. Now imagine if I would have done that for 8 years. Eventually, I would have had elbow pain because I let some asshole tell me, fight through the pain, that's part of the journey. No, it's not. When you were born in this world, you were born in this world with no joint pain. All the joint pain you've accumulated from years in the gym is because little tweaks in your form that you should have addressed a long time ago. You build a home on a shaky foundation, you will have to deal with that shit at one point in your life. So when you build a great body on a foundation of shitty reps, you might still get that body, but you will have a lot of aches and pains along the way. So the choice is yours, guys. One more time. I got it set here just high enough. If you're a tall motherfucker, go up. If you're shorter than me, go down. You don't want it higher than it has to be because you're forcing yourself to wrestle with the cable, okay? I have it on the meaty part of my palms. Even the position you have the bar in your palms matter. Maybe try some sets right here. Maybe try some sets right here. Bodybuilding is an individual journey. You must do what's best for you, okay? So, I got it on my meaty part of my palms. All right, see my shoulder? I'm gonna extend it back just a little bit. See my shoulder? Bam. Now, I'm in position. I wanna keep my shoulder and my elbow in a fixed position. Plant my feet, one in front of the other. I'm nice and still, and here we go. All triceps, control it up. Bam, control it up, 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 bam. And that's how you do a tricep press down with the bar, motherfucker, the right way.